Well, hello and welcome to this tab by tab exclamation of the awesome spreadsheet. Right, that's the start. We have the splash screen, which we should leave the spreadsheet on all the time, just in case somebody new comes in and doesn't know how to enlarge the screen by that mechanism. That's a brief exclamation of that. Right, the main menu of the system is here. We call it the flow menu. I can just get this thing right. For obvious reasons, because we have a flow through the process. We start off with either manually entering the data from the wells, the pump count texts, or we can do it automatically. Well, when it works, we can have a daily summary of all the wells in the area, the red, green and blue wells. We have a color trends chart. We look at the graphical trends and recommendations, actions review, automatically update the website, which works. And we have two mechanisms of analysis, or we will have. Now, that gives us a summary overall. Right, what we'll do, we go into the manually enter pump count information. And this is a typical spreadsheet. Now, the format of the spreadsheet is any white cells is manually enterable. Is what? and any grey or coloured cells is either conditional formatting or programmatically controlled or macro controlled and should not really be touched. All the spreadsheets are initially protected. However, it is a simple matter of going up to the review and unprotecting them. There is no password. Right, so here we have the well names down the left-hand side. We have the little computer number. Each number represents one of these little Arduino computers, which is unique and not necessarily contiguous, but unique. We have the dates along the top, and as you can see, we have today's date highlighted in yellow. I have just manually put in, I don't know whether you can see that, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 24, 26, 20, etc. Manual pump counts. Now, if we go on, click onto the simulated well that gave us that information, you will see here the well ID, the current date, the amount of activity liters produced, 88888, and the dates, and that's the total flow per day. Right, if we go back to the flow menu and go into the pump count and then say, well, let's say we didn't receive that text. Never received, so we can't put it in. What happens to the diagram? Well, you can see what happens to the diagram. We didn't receive that text. It gets a category of a purple event, which means it's worthy of note, something's gone wrong. And what's happened here is that the next day thinks it's got twice as much. And really, that amount you'll find will actually fit in there. So when you see characters like that, you can say, well, there was something wrong with the transmission path, the texting mechanism, or something. It doesn't really matter. The whole purpose of this is to get the well working. And this is working, no trouble at all. Right, now we go back again. And we can see the day summary. The idea is that we've got three wells, a green one, one red and one yellow, as it happens. We can, and that gives us a summary of all the active wells. We have a color trends chart, which gives us all the wells and their color. Now, the color is an indicative of the change of the date, let's say the 18th, the 8th, the change of that date over the average of the last 7 days. So it was sort of 100% error, or 100% out on the average of the past 7 days. On the 21st, it was 2% out, so it's green. These are yellow, and there's various shades of red, all conditional formatting. I haven't found this screen particularly useful, maybe because we haven't had that many wells. I don't really use it, but anyway. Likewise, we don't really use a date, this day summary either, so I wouldn't worry about too much about that. We might actually remove them. The graphical trends, however, we do, but maybe we'll have it in a different format. But here we have the well names, and we can see what we've just seen. That's the well name. Now, why do we do well names? Well, let's go back here. We have well names and we have numbers. The numbers refer to the Arduino computer, and that stays with that computer. However, the well that computer is associated with could change, and so we give the user definition, and it can change. And as soon as that happens, all hell breaks loose with spreadsheets. But let's ignore that for the time being. So it can, this computer can go onto another well. Right, so that's the activity liters. We call it derived activity liters because there are more information down here. We have the temperature of the internal temperature of the unit. We have the time of day, temperature, wells, voltages here, the pump count, the work day, it's increasing, and the amount of time, the power loop, the amount of time the computer has been on in 30 second units between the last text. And we plot the battery voltage and the temperature. We also have a calibration mechanism, and this is to convert the pump count into litres. We do this by looking for a time a man takes to pump 20 litres. They time it, calibration for that particular well, and then for a woman to do it, and then for a child to do it. It's remarkably consistent, actually. It's all around 1.5 minutes, so it doesn't really matter. But there's a facility there if they need to do it. Similarly, with the well number of men actively using the well, number of women, the number of children. And you can see we're going to get a calibration factor of litres per time count, which is roughly 4. So what you have is a pump count. Here we have a pump count. And we've got to take the difference of that, and because the pump count is contiguous, it continues increasing, so we take that that minus that, and that multiply it by 4, and that gives us the amount of water pumped that particular period. That's when it's automatically fed, because it gets all this temperature information. When it's manually entered, we get the same calculations but on different data. You notice this is the 8th, 20th of the 8th, so it is today, 25th of the 8th, and the temperature and all that sort of stuff was last year, just over a year ago. Right, let's go back to the other tabs. Flow menu, we've done that. Graphical trends, analysis, yes. Actions review. Oh, yes, one thing important thing is all in these graphs, there is a space, a white space for the well owner to make a comment on. The purple events are when something goes wrong, and well, we know why, we know what's wrong with it because we've analysed it. This should be in the comments. And what this next block does is look at all the comments from all the wells, and so this, once it's printed, will be able to give us almost an action list for the maintenance team. The next thing is to automatically update the websites, which it does at the moment in MHT format, and really we don't really want that because it's difficult to use. Never mind, it does that. And then we have the analysis tab. We not do an analysis in two mechanisms. First of all, we do a graphical a jog movie. This is in joke in a minute. And then we have also intend to have some sort of machine learning, but that is not activity at the moment. So let's go into the jog movie and jog geographic movie. You'll see here all the wells. Not particularly good, is it? Never mind, it's falling down. all the wells, and we have the date here. So this is the 12th of July. This particular well was wet yellow. I don't know if you can see that. And the rest were green. If I take this slider and move it, you can see that it, on the 14th of July, it actually went red. We can move the dates up. It went yellow and red again. There it goes, red. And if we move it up, you can see there's a continual problem with that well. Oh, and with this well, suddenly starts to come back into favour. So you can see this slider gives us an overview of the wells that we wouldn't get any other way, apart from this data movie as we're jogging it through the days. Right, what else? Yes, here we have the weather in Dar es Salaam, because if there is low pump count, maybe it's because they're harvesting the rainfall, which doesn't look like it at the moment. Only 4% chance of rain, so that is unlikely at this time. And yes, the problem that we're having at the moment is automatically entering the pump count data with ports. Yeah, but this one automatically updates the website.
Saving workbook and publishing graphs.
As you can see, it tries to tell us what it's doing, and it updates the website. Right, that's a quick summary. Hope that was all right. And yes, it's not very fast. In fact, it's very, very slow. We've got 35 wells along the tabs along the bottom here. Well, you can see all these tabs, 35 of them, and it's a 40 meg spreadsheet.
Transferring updated graphs to website.
And it's a 40 meg spreadsheet, so it's very slow. Now, at the moment, we haven't got anything like 35 wells, so we could reduce it, but then that just gives us a problem in the future, so I don't know quite what to do about that. Oh, yes, here we go. Whoops, sorry, I forgot. There we go, that's what it's doing. Which is beautiful. Oh, I've stopped it. Never mind. I can restart it. But anyway, one thing that doesn't actually work is particularly well at the moment is this. But anyway, that gives you a view of the awesome spreadsheet. Thanks very much for watching. Cheers then. Bye-bye.